Yo, what's going on, everybody? It is Saturday morning right now, actually exactly 9 o'clock. The plan right now is to go hit a workout with Brandon, same friend I showed you in a couple other videos who's prepping for his first show. And we are actually gonna go hit a chest and back workout in an hour at 10 o'clock. So if you saw my other video where I talked about making a split, talking about my own training split, I talked about how Saturday is kind of like a fun day where you can just kind of train where I just kind of train what I want, or so whatever's the least sore, whatever body part I'm trying to bring up the most. So me and Brandon decided we're going to do chest and back, which a lot of people don't really do, but I really enjoy it. You know, maybe just three or four movements for each body part. And I especially like supersetting the push movement with the pull movement, and the pump is pretty good. So I'm going to show you guys the workout as well, and throw the whole video down below in the description box. But first, I'm just going to show you guys my breakfast. So nothing special today. Just going to go with some eggs and oatmeal. I think I'm gonna go with 5 eggs. These are just, you know, regular Kroger large eggs. All right, so got my 5 eggs heating up right there, and then my 2 packets of oats right here. Gonna throw some water in there and just throw it in the microwave. All right, so here's the finished product: just 5 scrambled eggs right here, and 2 packets of the oats, and then threw some peanut butter in there, because like I said in the last video, if there's no peanut butter in your oatmeal, you're not going anabolic. So I just logged that first meal, my pre-workout meal, into MyFitnessPal, and let's get it focused. So we've got 62 grams of carbs in this, mostly from the oatmeal, 44 grams of fat from the eggs and from the peanut butter, and then 43 grams of protein. So solid pre-workout meal. One thing I do want to start doing is kind of showing you guys more of like my diet, kind of just how I go through eating all my meals and everything. I do count my macros. I don't count my meals or anything like that. So I want to just show you guys how I implement that kind of diet. And I'll probably be making like a full day of eating, stuff like that, kind of tutorial how to count macros and stuff like that, so you guys can try it too. All right, it's time to wake up. Just going to go with the same pre-workout I've been going with lately. Just the Muscle Farm Iron Pump. Honestly, if there's one thing I'm afraid of right now, it's like mixing these two up. So this one you take before bed, which I'll talk a little bit about more later when I talk about my supplements. And this one's a pre-workout. So I feel like one day it's just going to happen. Like before bed, I'm gonna take this, or I'm gonna be getting jacked up to go to the gym, and then I take this. I don't know. Hopefully it doesn't happen. All right, so just took pre-workout. Brandon's here. Show you guys the workout. Here we go. Definitely favorite part about the new apartment, just moved in a couple months ago, walking distance to the gym.
Hey, what's the move? Can I tell the truth? If I was doing this for you, then I have nothing left to prove. Nah, this for me though. I'm just trying to stay alive and take care of my people. And they don't have no award for that. Trophies. Trophies. And they don't have no award for that. Shit don't come with trophies, ain't no envelopes to open. I just do it cause I'm smoking, baby.
We made it. Trophies, ain't no envelopes to open.
I just do it cause I'm supposed to.
We made it.
So just got home from the gym right now, had a great workout, and the question I want to answer is, are supplements necessary to make gains? And for the quick answer, they're not necessary. For my honest opinion, they're not completely necessary. I think they just make that little bit of a difference if you really want to spend the money and invest in supplementing. I mean, that there's a reason why they're called supplements. They're supposed to supplement your lifestyle, your workouts, your diet, and all of that stuff. So I'm going to show you the supplements I take, because I do take supplements, because this is just kind of what I love to do. If I'm going to spend money on anything, it's going to be my body and my training and everything. So post-workout right now, I'm actually going to go with a protein shake, which I don't always do, but I'm a little low on groceries right now and going to make a few meals for the rest of the day. So the protein I'm going with right now is just a simple whey isolate right here. Just BPI, whey isolate, 25 grams of protein. I'm going to do 2 scoops of that, so 50 grams of protein. To get about 40 grams more carbs, I'm going to throw in this waxy maize, which I just started using. It's just a straight carb supplement. If you look at it, it's going to be just 37 grams of carbs, and it's just waxy maize starch in there. So basically carbs coming from rice, corn, stuff like that. And basically what that does is it's going to be fast digesting, which is exactly what you want after workout. You don't want anything that's slow digesting right after you work out. You want to replenish your muscles, replenish that glycogen, everything in there. So waxy maize, whey protein, any kind of simple carb. You could have, honestly, you could have rice cakes, even some candy, gummy bears, Sour Patch Kids, anything like that. White rice, white bread are the best things to have post-workout. So you could go the supplement route, use like a Carbolin, a waxy maize, a Cytogain, whatever it's called, carb gain, and you could go that route, or you could just go with food, and that works just as well. If I was to say there is any supplements that were actually necessary that every single person would benefit from besides protein, I'd probably say fish oil as well. Just got this one from GNC where I work at, and 300 milligrams of omega-3s. I usually take 2 twice a day, and it just has so many benefits. Like, it's almost like I almost consider it not even a supplement, just because no one gets enough, very very few people get enough omegas from just eating the right fish and the right healthy fats and all that stuff. So super important to supplement it with a fish oil for joint health, skin, eye health, brain health, so many benefits. So I definitely recommend using that. With a pre-workout, I showed you guys how I'm taking the Iron Pump right now. Basically pre-workout, caffeine, beta-alanine, stimulants, some nitric oxide, vasodilators, stuff like that. It's just gonna help you get a pump. And it's really not necessary. I probably take it more than I should. I just like having caffeine and stimulants and stuff. I just like that feeling of getting going and all that energy in the gym. So that's another supplement I'm taking. Another supplement that's talked about a lot, whether it's important, whether you need it or not, how to use it, what kind of take, is just creatine. I just go with regular creatine monohydrate. Not gonna lie, I haven't taken it in a little while, but it's just because I found myself being inconsistent with it. And the thing with creatine is, if you don't take it every single day and take the right dosage, even if you just skip a few days or something, it pretty much loses its value and it's not gonna really do anything for you. But what it is going to do, if you do take it correctly, is it's gonna replenish your ATP levels in your muscles. It's gonna give you much more muscle strength, muscle endurance. It's just gonna help you in so many ways. If you're a bodybuilder, then I really think that creatine monohydrate should be a staple. Super important. There's a lot of companies you'll find that come out with all kinds of crazy mixes with creatine. I won't name any names, but then they just skyrocket the price and say that it's better just because it has all this other stuff in it. But unless you really don't like, unless you have bad side effects like bloating, which some people have from creatine, I don't. Some people get a little bloated from the monohydrate. You could go with creatine hydrochloride, which is pH balanced, so you don't find that water bloating, carry that extra water weight. I would just go with creatine monohydrate, simple stuff, it doesn't have to be anything fancy, and you can get it really, really cheap at any store. And two supplements that are kind of a staple for me right now, I actually just ran out of, so I can't show you guys, but BCAAs, pretty much something I always take, super important for me, in my opinion, to drink during a workout. I mean, like I said, it's important to me, but not 100% necessary at all. If you have a good protein source before your workout, a complete protein, then you really don't need to supplement with branched chain amino acids. Basically, the idea is you drink them during your workout. As you're working out, you're lifting weights, you're pushing your body to its limits, you're breaking down muscles, you're tearing muscle fibers, and you want to avoid at all costs you want to avoid going catabolic, which means your muscles are being broken down, and which isn't good because, you know, then they're not growing, they're getting broken down. And the goal is to always stay anabolic. So like we joke about that, but like actually you want to stay anabolic because that your muscles are going to be in a state of growing. As you're replenishing your muscles, if you get amino acids consistently in your body, it'll just help your body get in that anabolic state and constantly be growing during your workout. Avoid catabolism during your workout when you're breaking it down. Just build it back up. And then the other supplement that I've been taking right now because I'm in a caloric surplus or bulking, whatever you want to call it, is a mass gainer. What I always do is I have all my food. I'm not really counting macros too consistently right now because I'm just trying to gain weight and having a little bit of trouble with it. So I've been eating all my food, make sure I hit my protein, lots of carbs, hit my fats. And, you know, lots of good fat sources, like I said, not really counting, but I'll eat all my food. Before bed, I'll have a big mass gainer shake if I'm, like, just finishing the day, like, whatever I'm doing. Doing homework, watching YouTube, Netflix, whatever, I'll just drink my mass gainer shake, and it's a super easy way to get a ton of calories. It'll digest while you're sleeping, help you stay anabolic, and help you get those extra calories really easily by just drinking them. And then the last supplement I'm going to talk about, one that I'm taking, is the same Arnold line as my pre-workout, and it's just called Iron Dream. You know, like I said, I might be taking too much pre-workout sometimes. I probably shouldn't do it like almost every day like I do, but sometimes it gets a little hard to go to sleep with my schedule, going to the gym late and stuff, so it just kind of helps me a little bit, and I just want to try it out. Like, I've been getting really good REM sleep, so I guess it's working. You know, maybe I'll keep trying it. All right, so to just wrap it up, those are all the supplements that I'm taking right now currently. Hope you guys learned something from it. Just want to help educate you guys so that you don't make the same mistakes that I made when I was younger and spending money on a lot of unnecessary stuff. There's very few supplements that actually are worth getting. And I could go into so much more detail with supplements and stuff. There's just so much out there. But to keep things simple, protein, fish oils, probably my two most important. Creatine after that, and then from there you could maybe go with a pre-workout if you feel like it's necessary. And then there's all kinds of other products you could take, but I like to just keep things simple, and that's what I'm taking right now, and that's gonna wrap up the video, guys. And just want to let you guys know, everyone out there watching this right now, everyone that's watching my videos and reaching out to me, you guys are the best. Thank you so much. If you guys try my chest and back workout that I include in the video, hit me up and let me know what you thought of it. And I'm going to be doing all kinds of workouts on here and giving you guys some free workouts to try. So thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys on the next one.